Questions for a Q&A. I have to open one of these windows to pull up. Hi Maya, hi Ernie, hi Christian, hi Spyro, hi JW, hi Scott. in some way, but I, so I don't want to sound like you're complaining, but while I was living in San Diego, there was a lot of challenges to be able to film ASMR sound wise in a lot of different ways. And I talked about it a little bit, but not too often. Grief over the past few years that needed healing, and we left San Diego. We bought a camper and traveled around America, so we spent a lot of time camping, and I thought I was going to be filming while I was camping. That a set up my camera on the, I put my phone on airplane, on my deck in the back. And I've also been taking yoga teacher training to become a yoga instructor. And as soon as I get certified, I'm going to start doing online Zoom classes and offering it to everyone. And yeah, and then I'll also be doing some more cool ASMR videos too. But it's a dream I've had for a long time to be a yoga instructor. Ever since I was 20, I wanted to be a yoga instructor. So I'm really excited to finally be taking classes for it. And I've also been writing a book and learning how to do digital art on my iPad with Procreate, because I intend on illustrating the book once it's done. While I was roaming, did I meet any fans or people recognizing me? No. I met some viewers, but while I was on the road, I did not. When I was in college, I just learned classical art. I didn't take any computer art classes, so I'm just starting out, but I like it. Okay, let me pull up that question list. What do you mean? How do you do that? Like for album art? Yoda's good. Kimsani's in the other room with Lee. I just saw some meadows and some sheep. But I would love to go. I would love to go see the Stonehenge. I just watched a seminar about the Stonehenge. It's on Gaia. It's called the Consciousness Expo. It just came out this year. It's really ear cupping short. appears, and then it's like highlights. My favorite Joe Rogan podcast guest. Oh goodness, what's his name? Oh, I'll think of it. What am I most passionate about? I'm passionate about so many things. Consciousness, healing. Spaceships. Gardening, my family, my friends, Sarah asks, what are my favorite little details of my home, or my absolute favorite part? My bed. And the yard of all the space. We're working on a big garden, and I love seeing all the butterflies enjoy the yard. And I have a little bird feeder watching all the birds. There's cardinals and finches. Yes, Graham Hancock. Thank you, psychic answer. That's who I wanted to say. I love Graham Hancock. Yeah. And because that's one of my dudes. So I was stoked to see him on Joe Rogan. Documentaries and the interviews, like on Beyond Belief with George Nori, or Open Minds, and I love listening to esoteric conversations and learning. And when we were in Sedona, I realized that Sedona is like the Hollywood of Gaia TV. Like all the cool, well not all the cool, but a lot of the cool people I see on Gaia, I saw in Sedona. I went to a UFO expo when I was there, and yeah, I saw a lot of people that I recognized their name. Do I believe in the afterlife? Absolutely. I have some experiences that I can go to the other side while I'm dreaming, and I've been able to visit my mom on the other side and ask her questions and interview her about what it's like over there. It's been really trippy. one is Lyra. You've seen parts of the other side too. Oh yeah, someone asked in the chat before I started for if I were to ask you guys questions. So I have some questions. Has anybody here seen a ghost? And if so, tell me. Magic Skies, I think. I think I changed the name a few times, but I think that's what it's called. Yeah, the 360 Magic Skies. I really love that one. Aries season has gone by fast, right? Time is just going wild. Oh, someone said, please let me know why you do that. I don't need to speak to my auntie again. Counter Z. So, yeah, I kind of made the intention that it was something I wanted to achieve, and I knew it was possible because I study shamanic practices and the way that they describe the dream realm is that the dream realm is like a big lake and the spirit realm is a section of that lake, and it's all the same substance in a way. A shamanic practice to think of a tree, and this can take practice and time, and to do at different times during the day, and then work your way up to it. And I envisioned a tree and envisioned going underneath the tree and getting a spirit animal and I asked the spirit animal to take me to my mom. That's also something I want to start doing in addition to yoga classes is shamanic journeying through Zoom as well, so stay tuned for that. I'll be hosting shamanic drumming journeys so you can learn how to find your spirit animal and how to travel all the different realms. It's very cool. Thank you so much, Common Sense. I'm glad you're back. It's great to see you uploading again. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for all the love, everyone. you saw a blue flame above a grave in a graveyard, a soldier. Ooh, that's very cool. We've heard things. We met Mason, so you have. I just bought the saw that Rex. Oh, that's beautiful. That was a cute little comic book. Yeah, I should get some new comic books. Alright. Yeah, let's start the Oracle. I don't even know how long I've been on here for. What time is it? Yeah, it's about time. Okay. Fishies. Yeah, Counter C. I will talk more about it in detail in a full video. So much to go over. There's so much to it. Oh, and also for these cards, you can include your sun, moon, or rising, actually. So, all right. Pisces. Okay, channel, see why Meteor Meisler dreams of the fox. They're my fishy, my Mercury is in Pisces. My sun is in Aries. My moon is in Cancer. On Twitch, and I'm thinking after I finish here of hopping on Twitch to do tarot readings tonight, personal tarot readings for folks on there. So my name over there is Cosmic Tinkles, so maybe after we're done on here. Okay, so I call upon my guides and or a message for Pisces. Right now, here's this card for Pisces. Mm-hmm. stuff of peace. Stay in the heart. All is well. Be at peace. Hi, Gold. Yes, I'm working on another Reiki video. Yeah. All right, the Dove of Peace. For Pisces, Sun, Moon, and Rising. Unity card I'm using. Lemurian Star Child Oracle. This is my favorite Oracle deck. So, a lot of people have heard of Atlantis, but not everyone has heard about Lemuria. Lemuria was around the same time as Atlantis, but it was more spiritual and, well, they like to go within and more into like natural forms of healing, and Atlantis was more into technology. Very general way of summing it up, but okay. Stay in the heart, all is well, be at peace, and for confidence, releasing judgments, heal whatever is arising. Card is, as a dove of peace, I am finding my feet to land in a human world that is coming to peace within itself. Because of their peaceful nature, the dove of peace might find it hard to communicate through discussion and debate. They remember harmonious collectives like Lemuria, where conflict was resolved through a vision of unity and love. I love that. Each would attune to the Divine Mother to receive blessings and to listen to her guidance. Would sing in light language together to find common frequencies of light, which help to let go of the mind frequencies. The Dove of Peace might not see any benefit in conflict, and therefore peaceful resolutions. While many humans only speak the language of the linear mind, which loves to create conflict. Do you know a dove of peace who avoids conflict and confrontation? This might be their shadow, which they can resolve by receiving love, compassion, and clarity. And to fully express their truth, even in a discussion. An affirmation for Pisces is, I am the dove of peace, and I am safe, and I am the safe landing spot. tell us the full story of the Dove of Peace. Do you know someone who is like a dove, who brings a message of peace? The dove has gentle songs of healing, multidimensional tones of light. It comes when you are kind, but it cannot stand human aggression or harshness. Would you like to bring peace to the world? Look at the dove. With its gentle songs, it is not affected by human thoughts and emotions because it can ascend to a higher altitude. From there, it playfully looks down onto the human world, spotting another place where it would like to land. Let's do distant healing together, an ability that you are activating, the Dove of Peace tells you. Sometimes it just wants to play in the sky and oversee the humans from a bigger distance. It knows that it doesn't need to get involved in the drama to transmute its message of peace. You might feel a dove of peace inside of you when you watch the news. If you don't know how to cope, the dove shares its wisdom. You are the most important news, the center of a mass awakening. Share your light freely. Themselves. Crystalline doves are coming into matter, and these new earth children may need something to help them land. You can be the bridge they learn to trust. You can be the brighter of better news, the bringer of better news. Dear one, in your heart, learn to trust. You can be the bringer of the dear one, within your heart. Within your heart is a shining light which invites them to bring their beautiful gifts and presents forth, which also respects their freedom if they should choose to wait a little longer. Shine your love with a beaming message of welcome, of unconditional love and acceptance. This gentle being will land where there is no longer any pressure to land, where they are allowed to just be as they are. Your welcome will help them to accept and inhabit their human body, and to engage joyfully with their human experience. Your inner child is also a dove of peace, and can sometimes carry aspects of shyness or timidity. A message of self-love and acceptance is especially important for you today. Give yourself this love, that all aspects that are hurt can come home encouraging, gentle parent to your inner child. Tell them they are a gift to the world. That they bring something unique and beautiful that only they can bring. Soothe their fears with gentle affection. Plenty of time and space for recalibration, and by releasing pressures, lovingly reconnect them with the light of the higher self, which brings peace beyond circumstances and logical understanding, and a safe passage into flow. So beautiful. In Lemuria, you have always felt a connection with the bird tribe, of which the dove is a close cousin. These bird beings of the ethers, not bound by a physical body, share with you their wisdom. They show how they soar through frequencies and dimensions to share light and distant healing, which is actually closer than many people think. Ascend to their skyways to remember light of truth, which brings everything back to its natural state. And the affirmation, I'll say it again for this card. I am the dove of peace, and I am the safe landing spot. See, because it's green. Look at that one. Tyrian Emissaries. Very cool. Emissaries. Yeah, I started with Pisces for some reason, but I should have started with Aries. Oh, thank you so much, Steve. Walrus, right? Oh my goodness, and Ryan. Look at this. bestow my nostalgia. What's up, guys? Those are two folks that have been around all the time supporting me. It's so nice. Right. So maybe I'm the only Aries. Okay. Ezra. Aries gang. Alright. Let's pull an Aries. I call upon my higher self and spirit guides to pull the best card to give guidance to Aries in this moment. I've never pulled this card. Actually, there's a lot of cards I haven't pulled. This is a huge oracle deck. Okay, so for Aries, Sun, Moon, or Rising, rising to Pleiadian frequencies, sacred bond. Healing clear space for higher energies. Very cool. It's like a hummingbird going through some kind of vortex. Ooh, this one has a guided meditation. Okay. Oh, thank you, Ryan. Yeah. It's a little mushroom cave. And I'm doing Leo. No. I'm doing Aries. I read someone said Leo. Yeah. Now I'm doing Aries. Yeah. And then I'm gonna go in order. You're Gemini, Justin. Lisa Gemini. Alright. So the quote for this card is, Pleiadians remind me of my source vibration, the cosmic heart source. The Pleiades remind me of my source vibration, the cosmic heart source, to clear old energy and heal old wounds. That's right there. Okay. Pleiadian beings of light are reaching out to connect to us in a space of love and truth, to make themselves known again. Enter into their vibration to be lifted up to a higher reality, a dimension of peace and healing. I hope that's what the guided meditation is gonna have us do. You have drawn this card because you are ready to be nurtured by the activation of your cosmic remembrance. You have the ability to access your Akashic records so that you can remember your natural affinity with the Pleiadians from times before their information became suppressed. Allow the Pleiadians to raise your vibration and to bring in light codes, which transmute your DNA. They attune the vessel for the human of light to walk on the new earth, just like they facilitated the Lemurians of Eden. Many participated in the divine plan of bringing the Lemurian heaven to earth. The Pleiadians were welcomed into Lemuria in etheric dream time before its physical manifestation. They brought their consciousness in the Lemurian realm, which was a very joyful event, a celebration of light. The Lemurians were infused with cosmic love, with light language of creation. This set a series of events in motion, so that heaven could descend onto earth. Pleiadians brought great wisdom to the Lemurian consciousness, a crystallization of the divine plan. They knew how to how a physical vessel for the human of light could be created, because they once walked the same path. Pleiadians were once star-seeded themselves by other star races. They were in much joy to pass on the divine knowledge of activating the physical body. The Pleiadians and Lemurians gave each other much faith in the star-seeded process. In divine synchronicity, the Pleiadians and other star beings cleared old energy from earlier civilizations and created beautiful vortices of energy and spaces for elemental beings and elves. Many beings helped to prepare for the upcoming evolutionary leap. Lectorians raised the vibration of the planet. The elven ones created a divine structure within nature, cooperation with the Syrians to prepare a welcoming earth environment. Many animals, plants, and minerals emerged to complement and welcome the prospective Lemurians. The Pleiadians then started to activate the DNA of the humans, offering them divine encodement. Form. At times, they were so excited to be in a human body that their etheric vibration blew their own fuses. Can you feel the bond you have with the Pleiadians? Pleiadians and humans are like parent and child. In a process of passing on divine wisdom, physical bond with Pleiadians, they can call on them to clear energy and bring in cosmic healing. You have this bond as well, a sacred connection of frequency healing, which exists on a personal and collective level. One day, the human children of light might surpass the evolution their star parents, the Pleiadians, in this divine plan. The Lemurians stabilized their journey into form, supported by their bond with the Pleiadians, and manifested the physical Lemuria. The Pleiadian DNA catalyzed their spiritual evolution of the Lemurians. In a stepping up in vibration, this process allows more spirituality, evolved beings to come in form in the ethers. In this way, the vibration was raised in steps. Until this work was no longer necessary, but the bond between humans and Pleiadians remained. Would you like to strengthen this bond to support you in your ascension with frequency healing and clearing? In the course of history, much of the Pleiadian DNA was deactivated in the service of egoic agendas. In the current ascension, the Pleiadian DNA is activated once again, and the Pleiadians would like to support you in this process. Call in Pleiadians to receive their great love and healing. And now we're gonna go on a whole journey. God of meditation. Sorry about my chair. So, for this part, thank you so much. Thank you so much. I'm gonna drink a little water, and then we're gonna go on this adventure to have a healing process with the Pleiadian frequencies. Pretty rad Monday night. Okay. Everybody get nice and cozy. Yeah, sorry about that. It's a squeaky chair. I was like falling off it. I had to move. Cause like, I'm like leaning forward. Okay. Okay. So everyone, just get yourselves nice and comfortable. And center yourself with some nice healing breaths. And we're going to go through this guided meditation together. You just close your eyes and listen to the sound of my voice to guide you. The vibration of joy is upon you, is calling you home. Refine this joy to find in subtle movement, voice, and touch. The Pleiadian frequencies are found in the language of light, which is a language of joy. Open yourself to receive light language so that every cell of your body can be attuned to this frequency. To raise your vibration, it is important to first connect to your physical body. Your physical body is the conduit for higher frequencies and a tuning fork, it can guide you to the right vibrations. If you neglect your physical body, you can lose your connection with it when you raise your vibration. But this is not where you are guided now. We want you to be on earth and in the heavens at the same time, without a split or separation. Connect to every cell of your body and instruct your vibration, and instruct that your vibration is rising. You can also be aided by gentle music or purifying scents like incense. Use the language of light to speak with the cells and with all of your body. No matter if you speak the language of light out loud or energetically, simply ask its codes of light to be with you. When your body is attuning to the Pleiadian vibration, you can start to communicate with stars even more. Intend to receive the Pleiadian energy and to communicate with it. Allow this vibration to come into your consciousness now by imagining that a Pleiadian ship of light is very close to you. It sends down a white beam of love and light that activates every cell in your body and starts to rewrite your DNA. Your consciousness is raised into a higher dimension so that you awaken your light body. Do you get a spacey or floaty feeling from higher vibrations? Your hands can direct this divine light to any place that needs healing or grounding. In this way, you integrate from higher dimensions into your physical body. Notice that your crown chakra is a divine funnel for multidimensional light which spreads to every cell. The activation of your physical vessel brings back ancient memories of Lemuria. Travel with this information beyond space and time, back to the beginning of Lemuria. It is here that your physical DNA was infused with light by the Pleiadians while you receive a powerful energetic transmission at the same time. Which is remembered in the genes of all humans. This attunement activated your natural playfulness, your enthusiasm, your musical abilities. The Lemurians knew the Pleiadians not as aliens, but rather as intimate friends that inspired them like spiritual parents. Have I've been waiting to communicate with you more. There is a network emerging on Earth. A network of people that attune to the Pleiadians. Through this network, the Pleiadians can descend on Earth to bring their energy of love, light, and oneness. Many inner processes can be initiated when you connect to the Pleiadians, because they are supporting spiritual evolution. You might release many old emotions that you are ready to let go of. Therefore, it is important that you connect to your inner child. Inner child needs to be nurtured and held in this process. If you are not in touch with your emotional processes, you might get lost in space that is disconnected from Earth. Therefore, keep in touch with the inner child when you are raising your vibration. Allow your vibration . You might like to be creative through making art, music, or jewelry. You might like to express your voice through kind words or the songs of light language. Or you might like to dance or go into nature. With all these activities, you can call the Pleiadians to raise your vibration. Remember the love and the spiritual intimacy that you had with your cosmic family in Lemuria to activate now. The Lemurians had a consistent energetic connection with the Pleiadians that helped them clear their energy. Do you feel like you need a clearing? Remember your deep Pleiadian connection, and it is already starting. Dear one, the Pleiadians are around you, especially in higher dimensions. Raise your vibration to connect with them and receive their love and light. And the affirmation for this card is, I am receiving Pleiadian guidance and healing. I open to Pleiadian light language. So that was for Aries. He sleeps very well. That's so funny. Okay. I love that card. Hi Tanya, thank you so much. Thank you, Three Toes of Fury. I appreciate you too. Okay, are there any Tauruses here? Either Taurus Sun, Moon, or Pisces. I'm gonna switch to a different deck. This is the secret language of light. My Venus is in Taurus. Second house also, so super Taurus. Man of culture, Taurus. Prism aesthetic, Taurus. Up on my higher self and guides to pull the best card for Taurus is right now. Horses, the card is to let go. The sword. And so, what is it called? That sacred geometry. Ceres Yantra? I think that's what it is. Ceres Yantra, sacred geometry. Let go. Take back your power and thrive. Let it all just be and take back your light. Stop trying so hard and breathe. Letting go does not mean jumping blindly into faith, but to release resistance you hold about a subject so your dreams and desires can be realized. We have all hung on to a person, place, job, or idea because we think it will give us what we seek, but hanging on is a result of unbalanced thinking. This imbalance has you needing compensation. You created a deficit by compromising yourself, thinking that it was the way towards your dreams. It was your choice to do that. Now it is your choice to let go and create from love instead of fear. You deserve to have what you want without compromising your truth. You cannot change what has occurred. However, you can change what you do from this moment on. No one has been placed upon this earth to make you happy, just as it is not your responsibility to make anyone else happy. Free yourself and everyone else of that idea that we must please others to be loved. You are loved. You are love. No matter what has happened in your life or another's life, you are love and you are loved. has happened in your or another's life. Okay, the meditation for this card. So, imagine that you're placing your hand on this card. Right on the little sword. And while you place your hand on that card, make the intention to release all hurts. Close your eyes and breathe rainbow light in and out. Of different colored light flowing to people, places, or situations that are negatively prominent in your life. In your mind, say to the person, place, or situation, "Thank you for being here today. This is a mutual gift of freedom for us both." Now imagine your ribbons of light dissolve. Watch them as they gently fade from view. Stay in this healing space until all your ribbons have disappeared. Breathe in and out and feel a ripple of energy move within you. When you feel ready, you have just set yourself and everyone else free to be themselves. Hi, Poppy Z. Thank you so much for all your kind words, everybody. Oh, Jay. Very nice, Jay. Yeah. I see the card again. Perfect message for you, Prisma. Beautiful. Tanya, I would say, any suggestions for help with trying to conceive, trying to be one with God, nature, and the universe? Yeah, I've heard of people contacting the baby on a spirit realm. In meditation, sometimes a baby gets two people together because they chose those parents, and I heard that's where Cupid comes from, that it's a future baby that is choosing their parents. I think that's so cute. And then, inspired reflections and actions for this card. There's nothing you need to be or do. Be where you are and accept this is where you are. Very be here now, right? It is not wrong or right to just be where you are. There is no need to explain or justify what brought you here. More details you give. to a story, the more it has a hold on you, and the harder it is to move forward from it. All situations and reactions where you are not aligned with your higher self show themselves. Chaos and crisis offer opportunities for reaching the deepest levels of your being and knowing yourself in new ways. Meditate daily to connect with your soul truth. Freedom is everywhere. Shift your perception and you will see it. You can release anything by allowing yourself to experience what you are feeling. And it says, for the journal work, to write down something you want to let go of. Recording it releases the need to store it within you. Just write the short and condensed version. Write it as a list, in point form, or in a secret language of your own. Write this down. Don't analyze, just observe and record the information. The next time you recognize this feeling in your body, stop, close your eyes, and breathe golden light to this place until it dissolves. Yeah, because sometimes we can bottle up trauma or emotions like within our bodies. That's a great tip. Golden light into it when you realize that there's a physical reaction to some kind of situation you want to let go of. And then after you do that, then open your eyes and move forward with your day. Love it. Alright, so that was Taurus, and now we are moving on to Geminis. Geminis, come on down. Resist. Like sitting on the edge of the chair. I keep like scooching forward and then to get like closer to the mic. Alright. So Gemini. I'm gonna drink a little water too. Let's take a card for Geminis for this moment. Best message for them. Aw, Ivan, thank you so much. joy. Next year, what the heck? Oh, thank you so much for your donation. Wow. Have I been on the internet that long? That's what, a decade? What? Discover what you love. If a thought does not give you joy, then search for one that does. Thank that thought for showing you where you don't feel joyful, and then reach for a pleasing thought. You can empower yourself by choosing joyful thoughts. You disempower yourself by choosing sad thoughts. What will you choose today? There is almost always something to make you feel at ease in every situation. It's up to you to find that. Try reaching for a joyous thought right now. Around your house, what gives you joy? Turn towards the joy in your life. If you can't find it outside, go within and create inner joy. It is not always the easiest thing to do. However, it is one of the most worthwhile things you can do. Direct your actions, and you will give without expectation. Joy is your natural state of being. Now is the time to honor it. Alright, and the meditation for this card. Close your eyes. Take a deep breath in. And imagine you're placing your hand on this joy card. In your mind's eye, placing your hands on the card. And as you place your hand on the card in your imagination, you feel your heart connect with joy. Feel how soft and loving this is. Close your eyes. Slow your breathing and allow yourself to be who you are. As you find joy within, breath and feel it carrying you deep into your heart to a place of solace. This is your sacred place where you can be who you are and just be. Feel infinite joy and love. Always available to you. From this compassionate place, send joy to yourself and others. Hold a vision of a balance. Hold a vision of a balanced and joyous world. When you feel ready, focus on your physical body and breathe joy into your life and into the world. And open your eyes and see everything through loving eyes. Revisit this meditation when you are feeling unbalanced to neutralize your feelings. Okay to feel sad. Learn to honor this without freaking out. If something is spinning your head around, you may like to affirm this during meditation. This is the affirmation. I would prefer the world and all people didn't have to experience any fear or pain. This is the way at this moment. Instead of trying to change the past, I will do all I can to bring about healing, rebuilding, and joy for today and the future. Allow all stillness. A joyous door has been opened. Stay here for as long as you would like. And then when you feel ready, focus on your physical body and breathe joy into your life and inspired reflections and actions for this card for Gemini is invite joy into your life. Read or watch your favorite comedy and laugh out loud. Put some fun music on and move your hips in a figure eight. It is to allow joy and love. Playtime encourages creative genius and access to greater soul wisdom. What are some things that bring you guys joy? I like to play frisbee. Big ring. can catch it with your head, I jump into it. And I like playing badminton. We have a badminton set with an LED light birdie. And I like to roller skate, even though I haven't roller skated in a long time. When I was really little, I remember my mom took us. It was, I think, the most exciting thing I ever did with my mom. She was kind of a homebody. I used to, we would go on more adventures with my dad. But the Ren Fair is like Renaissance Fair. Said we could each do one activity. Like we each had, I don't know, like $10 or $20. And I remember I got my face painted. I chose to do that, but then I regretted it because my sister got a flower crown and she kept it for years. And I was like, oh man, I made the wrong choice. And like dried it and would like wear it for playing dress up and everything. Hi Chris. Hi Leah. I am engaged. Next we have, where are we? We just did Gemini. Oh, now it's time for the Cancers. Are there any Cancers in the chat? I'm going to do like a time marker on this video for the playback. My moon is in Cancer. Aw, Justin, thank you so much. Thank you so much. Oh yeah, you're Gemini. Justin, that's right. Beautiful. I love Geminis. My North Node is in Gemini, so it's like my quest for this life is to become more Gemini. Did I do Aries? I did, Leah, but this video will be available for playback. And I also do tarot readings on Twitch, Oracle, and Tarot. So, oh my goodness, I need to shift in my chair. It might squeak. I'm sorry. It was like not the most comfortable. So yeah, I do tarot oracle readings on Twitch. I might do it tonight if it doesn't get too late. It's kind of getting late, so we'll see tomorrow if I don't do it tonight. Yeah, so we're on to Cancers. You'll be back, Rick? Alright, we'll be here. Alright. I saw someone say they were gay at the radio. Let me scroll up. Tanya says, from this Gemini, you're doing a wonderful job connecting. Oh, thank you. Yeah, I'm trying. Lee's a Gemini, so he's like a good, you know, I got a good, close example to observe. Hi, Evan. Thank you so much. How did I get into doing readings? My sister actually gave me my first oracle deck. Okay. It's the crystal oracle deck. It's a really good one. And now I have that two tarot deck, but I prefer one over the other, and 10 oracle decks. So it's, once you get one, it's like, it's hard to like, you know, it turns into a collection. Card for Cancer in this moment. Nourish. Look at that. Beautiful. So, these signs count for your sun, moon, or rising as well. And my moon is in Cancer, so this also counts for me. The Cancer sign is known for being the mother of the zodiac. Nourishing ourselves, because sometimes we are so caught up in nurturing all those around us that sometimes we can forget to take care of ourselves too. I open right to it. I love when that happens. I just subscribed, Leah. Thank you. Want to gush about some ideas, but like I also want, I don't want to jinx anything. Like if I like hype things up, I want to. Well, yeah, I have some ideas for like some old art that I haven't showed you guys. Some like older sketchbooks I thought would be cool to go through when I was really active with sketching. And, every day because I feel rusty whenever I do draw. So I heard that that's a really good practice to get back in the swing of things, to just work the muscles to draw, get it done, even if it's just a doodle. Nourish. You are love, and you are loved, is the message. This image consists of your soul star, Gaia, the earth of the soul, Gaia, the soul of the earth, and the divine cleansing that is expanding the love of all. Honor your temple, for it is the physical manifestation of your soul. In doing so, you honor the earth, for she is a physical manifestation of Gaia. Don't judge your environment or your body. Just be discerning about what you focus on and digest what feels up. Gaia knows how grateful you are because you are here. She wants to remind you that worthiness and ease are your birthright. You are creating a beauty, intimacy, and deeper connections with Gaia and your higher self just by being and playing on Earth. Feel Gaia's loving embrace everywhere. In nature, a backyard, a potted plant, or in your mind's eye. If there is something you want to change about you or Gaia's body, connect with your soul and be inspired by a new path that will lead you to your desire. On this planet, all is forever moving into more and more love. And we have a meditation for this card. You're going to imagine that you're placing your hand on this card. Or if you're watching on your phone or computer, you can put your hand on the phone or on the computer to connect with the energy of this card. Now imagine that you're placing the card on your heart. Move your awareness to a place within that feels balanced and soft. As you breathe out, let go of any resistance in your body or mind. Anything that feels hard. Focus on your breathing until your whole body feels soft and relaxed. Take as long as you would like. Focus on feeling and know you can control how you feel by focusing on the softness within you. If you find yourself being distracted by the outside world or your thoughts, gently bring yourself back to your breathing and your soft inner world. Float in this space for as long as you would like. Allow your soul to reveal your highest, most loving, most fun, most exciting, most abundant way to be in this world. When you feel ready, you can open your eyes and know how special you are to your soul and to the universe. And the inspired reflections and actions for this card have a massage or a beauty treatment. I would love a massage. Experience Reiki or another healing therapy. And the first thing every morning, spend 5 minutes doing something you love. When you take care of your needs, you have more energy to give to others. All right. That's the Nourish card. Oh, look at this warrior. Thank you for sharing that. Hi, Dave. Thank you for being here. Thank you, Lord, for being here. Thank you, Leah. Yes, it was very Cancerian, right? Alright, I'm gonna shift in my chair again. Alright, I'm becoming better at doing that quietly. Alright, next up, we have Leos. Are there any Leos in the chat? And that counts for your sun, moon, and rising. Yeah, I've mastered the chair. Yeah, the first time I did it, I'm gonna see if I can like go back and edit it. I don't know at what time. I think I'll be able to edit it out for the playback. So loud. Alright, so pulling a card for the Leos. that's the best card for the Leos right now. Watching at home right now, or in a playback. The Leos. There is only light. Yeah, everything is matter, and everything is light, and everything is frequency, and everything is sound, all at the same time. Alright. There is only light. Darkness is just an absence of light. Leo is ruled by the sun, so I think this is gonna be good. Light is sought after and extraordinary. Sweet, you asked Lee, because he's like modding. He's handling all the questions that I haven't gotten to. I appreciate you, Lee. Thank you. He's probably like, has like one eye open, falling asleep, trying to do everything. Light is sought after and extraordinary. We seek clarity of light, a lightness of being, and light bulbs. And light bulb. A lightness of being and light bulb moments. That's funny. Light bypasses the analytical mind and takes us straight. Your shining light. Be illuminated. Let light in. Today is the day to release any disturbances in your energy. Happiness will come. Seems too easy, but it is truly that simple. Until you realize this, you remain connected to the belief that struggle is a required, perhaps more respected, lesson-laden path. We often take on the belief that if we struggle, others will think more of us, and we will appreciate. When you go against your soul, you move away from your brightness. The darkness is a sign. It is time to feel your way. Meditation for this card. Imagine in your mind's eye you're placing your hand over this card. And set the intentions of letting go. You will begin to sense words and feelings. Remain calm and say to yourself, I let go of all that no longer serves me and come to peace with where I am. Everything you let go of will float to the surface, move beyond you, and simply float away like the layers of color in the image. This leaves you lighter and ready to branch out and rendezvous with your dreams and desires. Close your eyes and stay here for as long as you like. Feel yourself floating. Enjoy your lightness of being. When you feel ready, take deep breaths in and out to bring yourself back to your physical awareness. When you are ready, open your eyes. And the inspired reflections and actions for this card, for Leos, I mean anybody can do it, but this is a card for Leo. Oh, this is perfect for a Leo, because they're ruled by the sun. Greet the sun each day. Breathe particles of sunlight into your chest to lighten the load of your heart. Take deep breaths in and out. Imagine your breath is filled kind of calm, filled with calm, a kind of calm and peace. Each breath relaxes you more and more. And then go through your clothes and shoes and let go of anything you have not worn for a few years or no longer gives you joy. And the journal work for this card. Draw or write a story you often tell that makes you feel sad, bad, or mad. Then ask yourself who you would be without this story. Draw or write a new story that makes you feel glad, great, or at peace. Okay, now we're on to Virgos. Hi, Stussy. Hi, Sloan. Hi. This is the first card in the deck. I have pulled this card before. I'll share my experience with it afterwards. I don't want to interfere with your experience on it. So, feel free to share your experiences in the chat after we do this meditation. I'm gonna keep my water closer, even though it's like a little risky with the cards there, but so I don't rickety creak my chair so much when I move. Libras are next. We're on. You're in Aquarius? We didn't do them yet. I have Aquarius rising. Okay. Yeah, these cards are for your sun, moon, or rising. Alright. Everyone, we're gonna get our soul name. We'll try this. Receive the name of your soul. Your soul name acts as a link between your inner and outer worlds, enabling you to merge authentic wisdom into your everyday experiences and create a life from your heart. You placed your soul name in your heart. You explore your inner world and open your heart, you will discover the name of your beautiful essence. You are ready to awaken your heart and know its absolute fullness. You are safe to discover, connect, and receive. All your dreams and desires will be realized with an open heart. Ask for and open to receiving the name of your soul. It may arrive in a way you don't expect, but when it comes, you will know it is authentic by the way it feels. Liberate your heart and soul. You are worth it. For the meditation for this card. If you guys do this meditation, I'd love to hear how it works for you. So, imagine you're placing your hand on this card, right by this temple. Right on top of it. And become aware of and sense your the ability to breathe and focus on your inner world. Here you can remember who you are, where you came from, and what your passions are. As you sit in bright appreciation, your vibration rises. Reveal a shining light being of you who is offering you a key. I'm pointing to a door in your heart. Take the key and notice a name on the door. If you can't see a name, know it will come to you in the following days. Unlock and step through the door into the fullness of you. Feel at ease, soft and wise. Be immersed in stillness and peace. In this moment, you are in full alignment with your soul. Remember what this feels like. And stay here for as long as you'd like. When you open your eyes, smile. Inspired reflections and actions for this card are to open yourself to receive receiving the sounds of your soul is sending you. If necessary, ask for the communication to be louder or more precise. Ask your mind to be still as you do this and trust what comes to you. When you find a name or names, try them on to see how they feel. State out loud, "My soul name is blank." It might feel awkward at first, but keep going. You will know when it is right for you by the way you feel. You may feel a rush of energy, a tingling, a revelation, a quiet recognition, or a knowing. When you are having natural conversation with yourself, full of insight and profound conclusions, acknowledge that you are having a conversation with your soul. It feels like you because you are vibrating at the same resonance as your soul. And the journal work for this card is for 7 consecutive days. Say the name or names you're trying out, then write down at least 2 qualities about the name that brings a smile to your face and heart. When I tried to do this meditation, I saw writing on the door, but it was in another language. It looked like Klingon or something, so I don't know. Did anybody see a name? I'd love to hear it if you feel like sharing. Alright, and next up we have Libras. I saw somebody say they were Libra earlier. Hi, Pablo in Ecuador. Alright, I'm gonna pull a card. That is best in this moment for Libras. Philip and Sloan. Libra. My sister and dad. Sensitivity. We have some rose bushes in the yard. They're just starting to show a little bit of color as they're opening. I think a rose is a good symbol for Libra, because Libras very focused on beauty and art. Hi, Johnny. Yeah, I did a little Q&A at the beginning. This is gonna be a really long video. Aquarius. Yeah, I have Aquarius rising. So these cards are for your sun, moon, or rising. Okay. Sensitivity. Heightened intuition and compassion. Becoming more sensitive to the energy and vibrations that precede all physical creation. We can all sense these energies, but our rational minds often override our feelings. Sense beyond what you see with your eyes and hear with your mind. Bring together the most up-to-date information through your senses. When we are open to sensing and feeling love, it also means we are open to sensing and feeling fear. This clarifies the importance of actively choosing where you place your gaze and focus your energy. Okay. So imagine you're placing your hand on this card. And if you are on your phone or computer, you can put your hand on the card like that if you'd like for a moment. Take the energy in this beautiful shining rose that's floating in our space. Allow the beautiful representation of the flower of life to interpret the vibes all around you. Close your eyes and slow your breathing. Imagine your breath carries your inner glow within and around your body. Notice how this feels. Palms facing your body. Scan your body with your hands, starting at your head and working your way down. Allow thoughts to flow by in your mind and be open to sensing vibrations. Notice any change in energy. Spend at least a minute scanning your body. When you feel ready, imagine your inner glow surrounding you with the golden light of truth that will always support and love you. Breathe your newfound knowledge into your life. And open your eyes and feel how good it is to be you. When you become comfortable with this meditation, try turning your hands around to sense the energy around you. And the inspired reflections and actions for this card: sensitivity, rose card. For Libras, imagine you are surrounded by a loving, colored light of your choosing. What color are you choosing? I'm going to choose yellow. It'll be easy with my shirt. Allow this light to embrace and lift you space of love away from fear. Your light will be with you for as long as you need it. Check in with your gut and ask whether the energies you are taking on are helping or hindering. Then place your hands on your heart and ask, what energies am I sending out? Is my heart singing or shrinking? And what have your difficult experiences inspired you to create? How can you help yourself and others move forward in an empowered way? Write down as many things as you can think of. My stomach's starting to growl. I have chocolate next to me. I can kind of smell it. How can you help yourself and others move forward in an empowered way? Write down as many things as you can think of. And for your journal work, write down 3 beliefs that help you create your dreams and 3 beliefs that hinder your dreams. Focus on the ones that make your heart sing. I'm gonna eat some chocolate. What color? Did you guys pick a color to put around yourselves? What color did you do, so? And next we're gonna do Scorpio. I saw some Scorpios earlier. That's so funny, local person. Is this a light worker 24 hour support line? Basically, right? Hi, are you a light worker in need? Come by the Tingle Lounge Monday nights to contact your cosmic ambassador. This chocolate's so good. I'm so happy I put that next to me. You want some tomatoes from the garden? Hmm? We call the garden Fern Gully Farms. That'd be cool if I send out veggies, right? We probably will have extra, honestly. Sagittarius, Capricorn. Excuse me. Aquarius. Hi, that one guy. Hi, Brad. So we're gonna pull a card for Scorpios. You live with a Scorpio, Eve? You're a pitiful cowboy. Sun, Moon, Venus, and Mercury are all Scorpio. Whoa! Amazing. My Saturn is in Scorpio. What else do I have? I thought I had something. Oh. There's one of the other outer planets. My Sun is in Aries. My Moon is in Cancer. I have Aquarius rising. My Mercury is in Pisces. My Venus is in Taurus. And my Mars is in Aries. Leah. Those are my inner planets. Johnny asked, why does everybody hate Gemini? I don't know. I don't. I love Geminis. We hate Gemini. And yeah, I feel like within each element, there's like the bad guy. Like, I think Aries are the bad guy of the fire signs. And yeah, water, like the Scorpios are the bad guy of the water signs. Earth signs, I don't know who would be the bad guy. Probably Virgo, I guess. And like, you know, that's who like people make fun of the most on astrology memes and stuff like that. But you know, each sign has a high vibe and a low vibe. So it just depends on where we want to be. Alright, so we're gonna pull a card for Scorpios. What is the best card for Scorpio right now? For Scorpios in the chat, for the Scorpios watching in the future. Divine masculine for Scorpios. Looks like a Stargate with a magic fire inside a heart coming through. Turning into a lotus. The Scorpio is the only sign that goes through a transformation. It starts out as the Scorpio bug, and then they go through like a dark night of the soul kind of experience, and then they squash the bug for like an ego death. And it flies up into the phoenix? No. It flies up. Wait, what comes first? The phoenix or the eagle? Yeah, I was right the first time. It flies up into the phoenix from the ashes of the Scorpio, and then it turns into an eagle. So the eagle is the evolved energy of the Scorpio, where it can fly really high and like be able to see things from a distance and notice like any details, but they can also weave in and out of it from spirit and into the earth. It's the shaman of the zodiac. Right, divine masculine. So yeah, I was thinking that this kind of looks like a transformation, right? It's like the with the fire and the heart, and it transforms into the lotus flying up into the heavens. Everything has its purpose. You will not always understand what the purpose of something is. However, it is someone's creation, and that is to be respected. If you don't like it, let would it be the inspiration to create something more aligned with your soul's purpose? Consider all areas of your life and reevaluate any part that may not be working. You can be your own father by respecting your ideas and providing a way for them to manifest. A master of your own making. And to be a leader of your thoughts and emotions instead of a follower, stand your ground. Regain your self-respect. Pick yourself up and dust yourself off. Against or try to control external forces. This is a time for disciplining the way you focus and what you think about so that you can create your dreams. Meditation, this card, if you have a candle near you, light it. If not, just in your mind's eye, imagine that you're lighting a candle, whatever color you would like. Now imagine you're placing this card over your solar plexus, around your belly button. I'll do it. Gently close your eyes and focus on your breath. Here. The act of closing your eyes will move you into your inner world, yourself sitting high above a mountain, high on top of a mountain. From this excellent viewpoint, you can see the entire world with clarity. Survey your domain. Feel immense empowerment swelling up. Imagine you're blowing out your candle, for it is now relit as your inner flame and your inner fire. And the inspired reflections and actions for this card is at sunrise, give thanks to the sun for illuminating all creations of your life. be open to receiving inspired reflections. And solutions before seeking to help another. Find balance and harmony within yourself. Whatever the outcome, don't judge it, the others or yourself. If you want to save the world, you will create a world that needs saving. Decide instead to create multiple paths of empowerment where people can save themselves. Wow, that's beautiful. And the journal work for this card, draw or write about three ways the men in your life inspire your connection to your inner masculine. And that goes for anybody. We all have like the yin and yang inside of us. Now we're moving on to, that was Scorpio, and now Sagittarius. Hi Steve, thank you. Thank you for being here. Asks, have I studied the William Hof method yet? I did a couple of his YouTube videos a long time ago. I should revisit them. For the breathing, right? And then he goes into the ice baths. I have not done an ice bath. Well, I've been to spas where there was a cold dunk. And then you, like, jump in the cold pool, and then, like, go into the sauna afterwards. That was a long time ago. Yeah. Alright. Linux, Sierra, Sagittarius. Any other Sagittarius is here? Gio, I just want to say I'd love a garden update if you have one. Thanks for coming back to us. Yeah, it's still at the little sprout stage right now. There's a lot of little sprout babies. I have in trays, and we're just starting to put them into the ground, tucking them in. But yeah, definitely, I'd love to do some gardening videos. Oh, my chair is creaking. Oh yeah, here's Sagittarius rising. William Hof has changed your life. Yeah, I know. Yeah, he does totally profound stuff. I've been meaning to get. Sagittarius, I have a Sagittarius. Oh, still any. Okay, what is the best card for Sagittarius? In this moment, for those in the chat or watching, see you in the future. Okay. Color for Sagittarius energy. It's written in the British way to say color, isn't that funny? Vibrational impulses and light waves. Your perception of life is becoming more colorful. You are opening up to different colors and experiences. Color breaks up old black and white thinking and opens your heart to the beauty of life and love. The colors of the rainbow are variations of white light, reflecting the diverse of life, and they are all valid. Each color of the spectrum has its own energetic vibration that stimulates certain responses and healing. Different colors mirror your current physical, emotional, and spiritual state. Your soul uses this mirror to communicate your need heal or to embrace balance. Get to know what colors you are attracted to and the ones that repel you. You are love. And you are loved. No matter how colorful your or another's life is. The meditation for this color. Imagine you're placing your hand on this card. If you are watching on TV or computer, your phone, you can put your hand on the screen. Imagine you're placing your hand on the card. Gently close your eyes and slow your breathing. Inward on your breath and go within your heart. See nebulous clouds of color shift and move within your magical heart. Glide through each colored cloud, feeling their different qualities. Red is strong foundations. Orange is creation. Yellow is confidence. Green is healing. Blue is self-expression. And purple is intuition. From purple, you drift into a bright white light that shines from deeper within your secret heart. The light contains the blueprint of your soul. Feel it gently shifting to share important information with you. Float in this space for at least a minute and open to all your soul wants to share with you. When you feel ready, allow this wisdom to travel with you back through the clouds of color. Glide through red into your physical body and open your eyes when you are ready. You are filled some on my iPad. Oh, yeah, I was looking through this series called Amulet on my iPad. It's more like a graphic novel. And there's some I sampled that I was going through Oh gosh, what's his name? Mobius? Mobius. He did collaborations. Oh my goodness, all names are escaping me right now because I'm on the spot, not camera. The guy that did Holy Mountain? He did some comic book creations with him. I sampled some of them. I didn't purchase them yet, but I'd like to get those. Drazkowski? Yeah, Drazkowski. Hans Bjorkqvist, thank you so much. What a cool name. I love Bjork. Gently, my friend, the custom I have for you is one of my most cherished possessions. Oh my goodness, thank you so much. I'm so happy you like it. I always get so nervous with those creating custom videos. I'm like, oh my goodness, like, I didn't think of it. So I'm like, oh, I hope I'm fulfilling their vision. So thank you so much. And yeah, Jodorowsky. Mm-hmm. But I can't remember his first name. Is it Alexander? No, something with an A. Okay. Inspire reflections and actions to activate different color qualities. So this is the Sagittarius for anybody coming in. To activate different color qualities of your life. Imagine breathing a color for at least 1 minute. Red for action, orange for creation, yellow for confidence, green for healing, blue for self-expression, purple for intuition, purple for love, white for hope, and black for regeneration. Celebrate your diversity, uniqueness, and beauty. And encourage others to do the same. Enhance the energy of filtered or boiled water with color. Close your eyes for at least 30 seconds and send waves of color to the water. Oh, I love that. And your journal work. Wear a different color every day for 5 days. Use this information to create harmony in your life. Very cool. Here, I'm gonna send. Oh, thank you so much, John. Thank you so much, guys. Wait, what color should I send in my water? And blue for my throat chakra. I'm talking so much. Alright. Next up we have Capricorns. Do we have any Capricorns in the chat? There were Capricorns in the very beginning when I first started. Sending color in your miso soup, that works. Oh, I love miso soup. I have a tub of miso in the fridge. And I have seaweed and I have tofu. For Capricorn. Capricorns, it's time to let your light shine. Your Aquarius could keep you here next. I'm Aquarius rising. Someone made a donation to my PayPal. I got an alert. I don't know what it is, but thank you so much. I see my email is alerting me. Thank you, whoever that was. Thank you so much for your generosity, everyone. So beautiful. Your wife is a Capricorn, but she's currently in bed. Well, good for her. She needs to take a nap. She needs a rest so that she's ready to let her light shine tomorrow. I love these fractal patterns. This person. Is that the last? Yeah, there's 45 cards in this deck. And this is, we had Virgo at the first card. I know. Capricorn is having the last card in the deck. And for Aquarius, I think I'm going to go back to the Lemurian Star Child Oracle for that one. Last draw. Alright, so Capricorn, let your light shine and be authentic. Today, embrace your uniqueness. Say to yourself, I am so pleased and honored to be me. Embrace the parts of you that may feel a little strange. They feel this way because you resist experiencing the fullness of you. They can all feel a little odd or peculiar at times, longing to be like everyone else and just fit in. But compromise. Locking yourself into the pretense of what others want will strangle your soul and split you in two. Accept yourself. Set yourself free from judgment and what you perceive others think about you. Let your soul shine outward and inspire others to connect. The chairs creak. Others to connect, embrace, and shine their truth. When we are aligned with our soul, we feel loved and satisfied. We no longer need others to lean on, to fill our perceived voids, or to be different. Or to be different to who they are. Instead, we want to be with others for the pure joy of it. Create new ways towards anything that is of and you feel relief wash over you. You are beautiful. And the meditation for this card, it says, lie down, make yourself comfortable, and imagine you're placing this card on your heart chakra in the middle of your chest. Close your eyes and breathe deep. Rays of beautiful soul light pouring down on you. Feel calm, peaceful, relaxed, and at ease. Practice this feeling daily until it becomes your way of being. Don't let the outside world intrude, influence, or water down your passions. After a while, you won't feel overwhelmed or bullied by conditions, because you've chosen to live unconditionally. Imagine you are floating on a river of starlight, rotating above you are the moon and the sun. Creative silver energy of the moon, and feel them merge within your heart. This sacred union reveals the quality of your soul. Bliss, love, and wisdom swirl from your heart and join you with your dreams and desires. The starlight and your desires for as long as you would like. How wonderful it feels to be at one and at peace with yourself and all, where nobody or nothing needs to be any different. You feel your love, empowerment, and wisdom. The changes you have been seeking are an inside job. From this place, beam love and light to a person or situation or place. You are the pathway for your desire. Breathe into your body. Come back now and open your magical eyes. Hi, Spaceman Rob. This is inspired reflections and actions for this card. Take the time to know yourself throughout daily self-reflection. Select a great moment from your day to embrace, then name a difficult moment and aim to heal it. Take credit for all things you love about your life. Describe the card image in your own words. Explore the feelings that move within your thoughts when you softly gaze at the image. Whatever you see will be right for you today. Each time you gaze at an image, it will reflect where you are now. And the journal work for this card for Capricorn is to draw or write about all the things you like about yourself and all the things you do well. During your daily meditation, repeat them to yourself. This builds a foundation from love and will bring more manifestations and opportunities that vibrate with the same and higher energy. This will also make it easier for you to align with your soul. And now we have Aquarius for the last pull, and I am going to switch to the Lemurian Oracle, because these ones are like, the readings are pretty long. So it would like, and this video is quite long, so it would be even longer if I did more of the Lemurian. So for the last one, let's do a nice juicy long one. What sign are you? Oh, good, beautiful cowboy. I'm happy it resonates. Todd, what's the comfort for you? Because I've been getting some argument over silly things. What's your t-shirt or tank? I'd say all of them, probably. Oh, my chair is rickety crickety. Get in a new chair. Alright, what is that card for Aquarius? What is the best message for Aquarius right now in the stream or for watching in the future? All the Aquariuses, I'm an Aquarius rising. And we're in the age of Aquarius. And Pluto, I think, just... Was it Pluto that just went into Aquarius? Was it Uranus? I know. Saturn just went into Pisces. Oh yeah, Leo, Aquarius moon. Oh, hi Charles, you're Aquarius? Right on. Yeah, Aquariuses are cool. I love being Aquarius rising. Very important right now for age of Aquarius. I'm trying to like sense with my hand any subtle energy when I scan my hand over the card laid out. It's different for each deck, what they advise to do for that one. What they say for this deck. Surrender. Oh, very green. That's okay, the background's pretty green. Release misaligned energies. Retune to your truth. My golly, you're an Aquarius. A lot of Aquarius energy in here. One of the journey cards. Surrender. 121. Ooh. Release misaligned energies. Retune to your truth. Clear old trauma. Healing soul scars. The quote for this card is, I surrender to the eternal embrace of my loving creator, recognizing everything as a path back to the light and love that wants to bless me. Do you feel like you're fighting against the flow, or does someone expect this from you? Your heart is wise and orients towards truth and joy, even if others tell you to follow old paradigm rules. It is showing you a way out of fighting with reality and into heaven on earth. Can you listen to your heart's dreams, to messages that tell you abundance is possible? Mind will tell you of dangers and limitations, but your heart tells you of unlimited possibilities. My Lemurian Star Child, this card shows you the difference between the mind and the heart flow. Look at the Lemurian pool, which is shown on this card. This healing pool reveals great secrets when you see your own reflection in it. You might see yourself as the unicorn, which is symbolic for your spiritual self, your divine abilities and gifts. Or do you see reflection of the mind? If you see your old identities with their thoughts, emotions, beliefs, and judgments, and this is what you are surrendering. Have you tried arguing with your own thoughts or those of others? This is to fight with your own reflection. Do you forget that you are in a healing pool? You can be clear about your emotional energy. Sometimes you see a brother or sister in your reflection, which shows a loving connection with your Lemurian family, but it can also be a sign to let go if you are carrying any burdens for others. If you are taken aback by your own reflection, your old identities, then please and the physical eyes is only partially truth. You are the one who sees with the eyes of the cosmic heart source. Allow your spiritual eyes to see beautiful colors in the water. Beautiful shades of turquoise, emerald, and bright white are calling you to go inward, letting you know that you no longer have to follow the vicious circles of the mind. This is why you surrender in the peace beyond survival. The letting go of the will of the ego. Despair, because this process is hard for you, then know that you are being cleansed by the healing waters. This card signifies indeed real, even though it might not feel ideal. Perhaps you feel confusion because you surrendered to someone else. Surrender takes you into these feelings with the opportunity to heal them in this loving pool so that you can feel your heart flow and stand on your own two feet. As you put your hands up in a gesture of love for the divine, your call is answered. For an everlasting moment, you are one with the healing water, with your earth self, and with the unicorn, your spiritual self. Then you are spiritually reborn, with your light body fully activated, to walk your path of light on earth. And then it talks about attachments and roles. Identifications, roles, such as with occupation, family, knowledge, even Lemurian, if they have attachments, can become impediments to the flow of divine spirit and its impulses as it seeks to reach into our lives. The same is true if we identify as a victim, perpetrator, rescuer, with our past or with our emotions. What are attachments? In one sense, they are limits, places where we have got stuck, accepting less than the flow of God's grace. When we fear or beliefs in lack and scarcity, we hold tightly to what was, interpreting the flow of what truly is. Closing our eyes to what truly is in any moment is just one way we try to hold on to what was. Returning to the heart, to the present, connecting with our soul, and deeper still to our divine source self, helps us to release any attachments and come back into the flow of abundance and grace. This grace is like living water, like the waterfall in the picture, washing us clean and refreshing our spirits. Deeply surrendering to the cleansing purification of this divine living water brings us back to our fragrant freshness, our lightness, and our truth. This is the way, the truth, the life. Surrendering to love and life. Sometimes you feel sensitive to others because you are picking up their wounds and misalignments, and these are resonating somewhere within you because you have similar energy in your field to clear. These sensitivities or vulnerabilities to the thoughts and opinions of others are gifts. They help to see where you need to surrender further to God's love and perspective, to your truth, and away from misidentifications. When we surrender to love, it can feel like we are taking our first steps again. And indeed, we in a new stage of development. In this stage, we are letting go even more of our sense of who we are, the ideas of identity we formed with clear vision, which we have been carrying all our lives. Some of these are very subtle, process of finer and finer purification and release as we open the door and let more and more life in. In reality, those identifications are just being replaced by more truthful ones. We are learning to discern our truth from the sometimes toxic, sometimes yourself, am I that? When you doubt yourself or your worth in some way, look into your heart for your answer to both your own questions and those of others. There you will find your answer that you and they are love. You are a beautiful being of light. If you see you have made an error, then it is healing to acknowledge that and to seek the way of your shining truth to act in alignment with that. The more we are able to align and surrender to the flow of God's love, acceptance, grace, and truth, the more our lives reflect that. Joyful creation and co-creation with your brothers and sisters, joyful living, miraculous healing, and wholeness are the new life energies that are returning to this planet. This is the new Lemuria. The affirmation for this card: I surrender ever deeper into a loving embrace. When I remember to surrender, I am shown a lighted path lined with joy. I surrender even deeper into did it buffer? Did you get the light language part? And for you, you heard everything. I'll just say the light language part one more time. Es anima ti ki anima ate I ti ke aya. Just in case you missed it, I think that's beautiful. You lost maybe 20 seconds. Oh, the affirmation is: I surrender ever deeper into a loving embrace. When I remember to surrender, I am shown a lighted path lined with joy. I surrender ever deeper into a loving embrace. When I remember to surrender, I am shown a lighted path. A lovely card. It worked out to start with Pisces and work our way through. And we did the first card in the Secret Language of Light. And the last card in it too, so we had like a bookend experience there. Alright. Hi Jan. Hi Miss Boots. Hi Yancy. Hi Zenon and Tucson. Hi HJC. Okay everyone. Thank you so much, everyone. I do tarot readings on Twitch TV. Also, if you enjoy this, it's a little. I was gonna jump over there and do tarot readings, but this went on longer than I thought it would. So yeah, it's 12:41 a.m. for me, and yeah, but I'm gonna be on Twitch tomorrow around 7:30. Twitch stream. So, I'm probably gonna go, I might make some miso soup from all that miso soup talk. Thank you so much. And, yeah, I have some good ASMR videos coming soon. I also have a vlog channel. Film more for it or Yeah, just stay, yeah, keep an ear out. I got a lot of cool stuff planned. And, thank you so much, everybody, for being here. And, I'm so happy that you enjoyed the card pulls and the brushing and the ear cupping. And it's really, really nice experience. Oh, Justin, thank you so much. Thank you so much for being here, everybody. It's really a beautiful experience. I'm so happy we could share this together. And we all can learn from the cards, even if it's not for, you know, I pulled for that sign, but we can always, like, learn from each card individually. So we're all learning. Thank you so much. I appreciate you, and...